All right, Mr. D, let's talk a little bit about lawn chemicals, and let's start with the Phenoxy herbicides. 2,4-D is one of those.
2,4-D is one of them. The benzoic acids, Dicamba is another Phenoxy herbicide.
Right.
Been around for a long time. Phenoxy herbicides have been around since 1946,
long time.
Believe it or not. Best known ones are 2,4-D, 2,4-5-T is another well-known one. A few years ago, you don't hear much about that anymore. Mm-hmm. A combination of 2,4-D and 2,4-5-T made up a material called Agent Orange, which was used back in the Vietnam War. Mm-hmm. Great product for 2,4-5-T is really good on killing woody ornamentals. Used it extensively in Texas to control mesquite in pastures and doesn't hurt grasses.
Okay.
But there was a problem with dioxin, and 2,4-5-T is off the market now because of that problem.
Okay.
But 2,4-D is still around. Not the same product, not the problems with dioxin that we had with 2,4-5-T. But in the 2,4-D, 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid, but really, really interesting herbicides. And the Phenoxy herbicides are auxin inhibitors. They mimic auxins, naturally occurring auxins that are in plants. And so they really just cause the plants to grow themselves to death.
Mm-hmm.
When you treat and they're systemic. They're systemic, meaning that if you get a little bit on a plant, it translocates throughout the whole plant. Doesn't immediately kill the plant, but over a period of 2 or 3 weeks maybe, the plant will start to go down and you'll start to see symptoms of curling, downward growth.
Yeah.
It's actually cell division, rapid cell division. The plant is actually growing itself to death. And very safe. As far as mammalian toxicity is concerned, safe for around humans, but it's pretty deadly on mostly broadleaf plants.
Right.
That's 2,4-D.
That's 2,4-D. What about dicamba?
Dicamba, it's a benzoic acid.
Mm-hmm.
It's also in the Phenoxy herbicide family and works exactly the same way. It's an auxin, type inhibitor, and it causes or it mimics the naturally occurring auxin that's in a plant. And basically causes very similar symptoms, a lot more leaf cupping with as the leaf is growing and it will cup. With 2,4-D, you have stem elongation and like a tomato plant may go up and around and back up again and
yeah,
look like
twisting.
Kind of spaghetti, something like that.
Yeah.
But and there's different salts of dicamba. I know. In the last couple of years, BASF and Monsanto have released, and also DuPont have released a less volatile form of dicamba. A lot of dicamba and 2,4-D are present in a lot of lawn chemicals, but read that label.
Sure.
Do not apply any of these Phenoxy herbicides when the wind's blowing 15 miles an hour and you have neighbors next door with broadleaf. Remember, it kills broadleaf weeds.
And most of your
it also kills broadleaf flowers and
broadleaf
shrubs,
and
it can damage broadleaf trees.
Mm-hmm.
So, and also high temperatures.
That's right.
If the temperatures are during really hot conditions, don't need to use it. And you don't need to use it when there's a temperature inversion, when there's no wind.
Mm-hmm.
When there's absolutely no wind right about sundown, when fog's kind of hanging out there, well, that's kind of what some of these herbicides do.
They just hover.
Especially the older formulations, which the older formulations of dicamba are what are the dicambas that are present in all of the lawn materials. Only the agricultural industry has access now at this point to the newer low volatile forms.
Okay.
They're restricted use pesticides.
That's right.
They've been, by EPA has declared them to be restricted use pesticides. The older, more volatile forms are not restricted use and any homeowner can buy them. And the only reason they're restricted use is because of their potential to move.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's kind of, we got some work to do there, but if you follow the label, they're really, really good to use in the early spring.
Mm-hmm.
Before a lot of things have greened up, when your target weeds are out there, but the flowers aren't, and
sure.
You can use them then. But pay attention to wind. You are responsible for your drift.
That's right.
It's just like when you're driving a boat, you're responsible for your wake. Well, when you're spraying a pesticide, you're responsible for wherever that goes if the wind's blowing.
Thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, please click the subscribe button below.